Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome University of Arkansas student Trey Odell to the stage.
Let's do it for our campus, let's do it for our pride. How we ever gonna know if we never try? Old man to the walking names, time to show the world the reason for our fame, yeah. It's time to go the distance. Take a chance, change the world, yeah, we in this. Be a hero, let's take flight. Let everybody know you raise it back for life, singing, hey, 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 hey. For our country, let's do it for our state, yeah. Make our dreams come to life, no time to wait. For education, the world is ours. When the lights come on, we're gonna sing it loud. It's time to go the distance, take a chance, change the world, yeah, we in this. Be a hero, let's take flight. Let everybody know, you love Arkansas for life, singing, hey, 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 hey. Let me hear you say, Pixaway, Pixaway, we're champions for infinity. Pixaway, Pixaway, hands up. Let me hear you say, Pixaway, Pixaway, we're champions for infinity. Yeah. Cause it's time to go the distance. Take a chance, change the world. Yeah, we in this. Be a hero, let's take flight. Everybody know you love Arkansas for life. Time to go the distance. Take a chance, change the world. Yeah, we in this. Be a hero, same flight. Everybody know you love Arkansas for life. Singing, hey, 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 hey. Peace away, peace away. Thank you.
Please welcome Vice Chancellor for Advancement, Mark Power.
Well, good evening. It is wonderful to see everybody tonight. How about that performance by Trey? Wasn't that fantastic? Let's give Trey a round of applause. You know, that song, Arkansas for Life, actually was written by Trey for Campaign Arkansas. And we asked him to play that tonight because tonight is about celebrating philanthropy and success. And the wonderful thing about this is that Trey actually embodies both. Trey is a singer-songwriter, as well as a student in the honors, in the Walton College honors student studying supply chain management. He is also the recipient of several scholarships, including a vocal scholarship in the Honors Choir Schola Cantorum, as well as a Brandon Burlsworth Memorial Scholarship. Now, these scholarships have enabled Trey to focus on his studies and his great passion, which is music. But we know students aren't the only ones who benefit from philanthropy. Private support is critical to advancing the careers of faculty as well. So that's why we've asked a few faculty members to help us out tonight as co-hosts. They know how important philanthropy has been in their careers and appreciate the opportunity to let you know what it has meant to them. And I do too. So let me thank you all for joining us. We're really delighted that you could be here. Philanthropy is vital to the University of Arkansas's success. We want to show appreciation by recognizing those who have been instrumental in getting us where we are today, a university that's thriving like never before. Tonight's about honoring you who have honored us with your generosity and commitment. Tonight is about giving back to you. Now, before I invite our first faculty co-host to the stage, I'd like to acknowledge some special guests. First, we have the pleasure of welcoming President of the University of Arkansas System, Don Bobbitt, and his wife, Susan. Several members of the Board of Trustees are with us here as well with their spouses, including Tommy and Sylvia Boyer, Ben and Janet Heidemann, and Mark and Angela Waldrop. Would you give them a round of applause? We also would like to welcome Dave and Jane Gearhart, as well as John and Mary Lib White. It is so good to have our former chancellors here tonight. All right, now for our first co-host. Dr. Angie Maxwell is the Diane D. Blair Associate Professor of Southern Studies in the J. William Fulbright College of Arts and Sciences. A professor of political science, she is also the director of the Diane Blair Center for Southern Politics and Society. Dr. Maxwell is an award-winning author and editor of several books and articles. She's also former ASG president of the university. So if you would, please help me welcome Dr. Angie Maxwell.
Good evening. Thank you so much for coming tonight. It's an honor for me to join the celebration of giving, because I personally know how much it means to our students and to my fellow faculty. As Mark indicated, we're celebrating philanthropy and success tonight. For a faculty member, there are many ways to measure success: winning grants, publishing papers and books, patenting research, and earning invitations to professional societies are among of the few ways that we do it. But perhaps the most fulfilling measure is helping your students achieve their dreams. We have a brief video about one of our finest professors who is helping his students do exactly that.
In his nearly 40 years at the University of Arkansas, distinguished professor of chemistry and biochemistry, Roger Kepi, has mentored more than 35 honors students. His impact on their development as researchers cannot be overstated. His students have won 4 National Science Foundation pre-doctoral fellowships, 7 Goldwater scholarships, and co-authored 7 papers published in prestigious journals. His students have also gone on to some of the most acclaimed medical schools in the country, including Cornell and Georgetown, in recent years.
Anything they do here tends to open doors for the next step. In many cases, the next step is further education. More and more, you're seeing undergraduate research is a significant stepping stone towards the next opportunity.
Kelsey Sparks spent 3 years doing research with Dr. Kepi as an undergraduate. This research became her honors capstone thesis and even resulted in an article published in a leading journal, Biochemistry, on which she was the lead author, a highly unusual accomplishment for an undergrad. She's now a 4th-year medical student at the University of Arkansas for Medical Sciences.
He's extremely supportive and encouraging. I don't think I would have made it through all of the papers and the revisions that you have to go through. And I think a lot of that is Dr. Kepi's mentorship, you know, his encouragement, his ability to see the end product and where we're going.
Second-year UAMS medical student Vasu Suresh Kumar had the opportunity to work with Kepi as an undergraduate as well.
You know, working under Dr. Kepi has been such a transformative experience for me. And not only did I gain the affirmation in doing research that I really loved science and, you know, how science plays a role in medicine, but I also learned a lot of life values, like perseverance, persistence, resilience.
One of the first things we do with our students is to encourage them to write for one of the fellowships. And in doing that, the students begin to think about their project, try to write their goals in a way that's clear and concise, so they begin to get a vision of what they're doing. And with the proper mentoring and the resources that we have, they're guided and then they're successful.
Kelsey and Vasu capitalized on a great opportunity to work with Kepi. Now it's Carly Lipinski's turn. Carly is a current honors student working with Dr. Kepi.
Dr. Kepi has just influenced me greatly. I was able to get a summer research internship. He's allowed me to go to these conferences like Biophysical Society in New Orleans this year.
What I get actually comes on several levels. New ideas come from the students, so working with students helps the whole project. The other gratifying thing, of course, is to see their success.
He's a very high-end, internationally ranked researcher who still is willing to partner in a very professional and intense way with undergraduates.
Ultimately, Roger Kepi is helping outstanding students maximize their potential and fulfill their professional dreams.
He has been the most influential professor, teacher in all of my life. And I just don't mean in college, but I mean like all the way through.
That almost makes me wish I'd studied biochemistry with Dr. Kepi. While I owe a debt to faculty like him, my own story of student success depended truly on the generosity of the people in this room. When I was 17, I started receiving promotional mail for universities across the country. I had scored well on one of those standardized tests, which I know now put me on some kind of mailing list. My mother, if she got the mail before I did, tossed a lot of it. She wasn't trying to be unkind. I think she just didn't want me to get my hopes up. No one in my family had ever left Louisiana, and I think the unknown scares most of us more than we can articulate. And there were no family resources to fund such a dream. The packet from Fulbright College at the University of Arkansas arrived on a day when I was the first one home. When I opened it, the first image I saw was a photograph of Old Main rising through a cloud of white fog. To me, for reasons I still really can't explain, it seemed to be the most peaceful place on earth. The application for admission and the private scholarship included one essay question, and of all the packets I opened then and since, it remains the most poignant of questions. Quoting from Graham Greene's 1940 novel, The Power and the Glory, the essay prompt read, "There is always one moment in childhood when the door opens up and lets the future in. Describe that moment." I remember thinking that maybe this was that moment for me. But I knew I shouldn't write that, and I've long forgotten what I submitted. I do know, and this is something I never do, I cut out that picture of Old Main, and I tucked it in my desk drawer. And I know because it's still in my desk drawer at home 22 years later. When my mom dropped me off at the dorm before classes, it was the farthest distance she had ever driven. And back then, there was no 540 or I-49, just the old 71, curving up the mountain and increasing her anxiety at every turn. We made one stop at what was then Boatman's Bank to deposit the $250 I had managed to save waiting tables. I had no cell phone, no credit card, no car, and I did not know a single soul. What I did know was that I had an opportunity now, away from a difficult life, in a peaceful place, all made possible by the goodwill of total strangers. Many of you have given to scholarship funds over the years, and scholarships are a really extraordinary thing when you think about it. Someone donates their hard-earned money to give a kid like me a chance for a better life. Your gifts not only give them an education, but also, in very real ways, save their lives. And you have given to me time and time again. When I was packing after graduation, I went to the bank to close out my checking account. I was due to start a PhD program in Austin, but had gotten an internship in DC for the summer. I had $6 left in the account. But I had also received an award from the Alumni Association at what they now call the Seniors of Significance Banquet. It included a check that I cashed that day and that fed me all summer. Now, decades later, I work in Ole Miss, running a research center sustained by the commitment of Jim and Nancy Blair, who are more than philanthropists, they are family. Now, I'm on the other side of the desk, trying to support the success of my students in any way that I can, as was done for me. Most of them have no idea how smart they are. All they need is a safe place to develop their minds. You have given them that, and it is not a small thing. On behalf of them and myself, I want to acknowledge your generosity and say thank you. I'd now like to invite President Bobbitt and Chancellor Steinmetz to convey pins and medallions to our first Towers of Ole Miss recipients.
John D. and Jane Suzanne Alford. John D. Alford received a Bachelor of Science in Business Administration and a Doctor of Law from the University of Arkansas. Jane Suzanne Alford received a Bachelor of Arts in Journalism from the University of Arkansas. John is the co-chair of the Campaign Arkansas Law School Unit Committee and serves on the Campaign Arkansas Steering Committee. John and Jane have supported a variety of areas on campus and established the John D. and Jane Alford Endowed Scholarship for Tribal Citizens. John D. and Jane Suzanne Alford, Towers of Ole Miss. John C. Berry and Richard L. Anderson. John C. Berry is a member of the Campaign Arkansas Student Affairs Unit Committee and a board member of the Pride Alumni Society. Both he and Richard L. Anderson are members of the Arkansas Alumni Association, the Chancellor Society, and Thoroughbreds. John established the Pride in Education Scholarship and has also supported the Jane B. Gerhardt Full Circle Campus Food Pantry. Both John and Richard have generously contributed to a variety of areas on campus, including the aforementioned scholarship, KUAF, and the Arkansas Alumni Association. John C. Berry and Richard L. Anderson, Towers of Ole Miss. Jean and Anne Bordelon. Jean Bordelon received a Bachelor of Science in Agriculture, and Anne Bordelon received a Bachelor of Science in Business Administration, both from the University of Arkansas. Anne is a member of the Heritage Society and serves on the Campaign Arkansas Steering Committee, Campaign Arkansas Walton College Unit Committee, and the Dean's Executive Advisory Board for Walton College. The Borderlands have established the Faculty Innovation Endowed Fund for the benefit of the Sam M. Walton College of Business. They've also designated gifts to the Walton College Dean's Excellence Fund, Delta Gamma House Building Fund, and the Accounting Department. Jean and Anne Bordelon, Towers of Old Maine. Stephen and Tricia Chafin. Stephen Chafin received a Bachelor of Science in Business Administration from the University of Arkansas. Stephen and Tricia are members of the Chancellor Society, Thoroughbreds, and Arkansas Ambassadors. Stephen is a member of the Arkansas Alumni Association, a member of the Campaign Arkansas Walton College Unit Committee, and is on the Walton College Dean's Executive Advisory Board. Together, they established the Chafin Family Endowed Scholarship to benefit the Walton College. They've also supported the Walton College Alumni Society Scholarship, the Walton College Need-Based Scholarship, and the Alumni House Campaign. Stephen and Tricia Chafin, Towers of Old Maine. John L. and Andrea Connor. John Connor earned a Bachelor of Science in Business Administration from the University of Arkansas. John is a member of the Campaign Arkansas Walton College Unit Committee and the Walton College Dean's Executive Advisory Board. Through his company, Greenway Equipment Incorporated, John established the Greenway Leadership and Business Scholarship Fund, the Greenway East Arkansas Excellence Fund in the Sam M. Walton College of Business, and the Greenway Agricultural Leadership Scholarship. Together, John and Andrea have supported other university initiatives, including the Arkansas Alumni Association membership-funded scholarship and Walton College. John L. and Andrea Connor, Towers of Old Maine. Philip Glynn and Marty A. Crandall. Philip Glenn Crandall is a professor of food science, and Marty A. Crandall is an instructor within the Dale Bumpers College of Agricultural, Food, and Life Sciences. Philip and Marty are members of the Chancellor Society and Thoroughbreds. Together, they have generously supported multiple initiatives, including the Graduate Education Fund in Food Science and the Gene Tyson Child Development Study Center. Additionally, Philip Crandall has made significant contributions to the Retail Food Safety Program at the Arkansas Agricultural Experiment Station. Philip Glynn and Marty A. Crandall, Towers of Old Maine. James M. Davis and Marcia Elaine Ramsey Davis. James M. Davis received a Bachelor of Science in Electrical Engineering, and Marcia Elaine Ramsey Davis holds a Bachelor of Science in Education, both from the University of Arkansas. James is a member of the Arkansas Academy of Civil Engineering. James and Marcia are both members of the Chancellor Society, Thoroughbreds, and the Arkansas Alumni Association. The Davises have established the Jim and Marcia Davis Endowed Graduate Fellowship in Electrical Engineering. They've also supported other areas of the university, including the College of Education and Health Professions. James M. Davis and Marcia Elaine Ramsey Davis, Towers of Old Maine. Congratulations to all of our recipients. We now invite you to enjoy the first course of the evening. Tonight's dinner, provided by Chartwell's, will be complemented by music performed by the Inspire Soul Band from the U of A Department of Music and Department of Theater. Please enjoy both the music and your dinner. Thank you.
Thank you.
We'd now like to welcome our second faculty co-host. Dr. Jean-Francois Molinet is the Tyson Foods Endowed Distinguished Professor in Sensory Science, head of the Department of Food Science in the Dale Bumpers College of Agricultural Food and Life Sciences, and director of the Institute of Food Science and Engineering. Since joining the university in 1996, Dr. Molinet has received three Department of Food Science Outstanding Teaching Awards, an Outstanding Research Award, the John White Team Research Award, and was named an outstanding faculty member for his department. Please welcome Dr. Jean-Francois Molinet.
Good evening. So apparently the main course actually came first tonight with Angie Maxwell. So Dr. Maxwell did an outstanding job. And so I'm not sure what I have to say is quite as exciting or interesting. But let me first thank the organizers of the event for the opportunity to be here tonight. I'm here really mostly to thank benefactors and to recognize the crucial role they play in the advancement of faculty careers like mine and student experiences. Endowed positions often play a critical role in whether a faculty member elects to stay at the University of Arkansas or move on to a different institution. Indeed, endowed positions typically provide more competitive salaries to faculty and some measure of prestige as well. However, these endowments can provide much, much more than that. For instance, in my case, as the holder of the Tyson Professorship in Sensory Science, I've been able to do a lot of things that I would not have been able to do otherwise. These include providing graduate assistantships to students working in my lab, students who are vital to the research mission of the university. These professorships also helps to support student travel to prestigious conferences where students can present their work to worldwide audiences. And in addition, some of these funds are used in my lab to provide hourly wages to undergraduate students who can engage in research. These are all central to advancing our research mission at the university, supporting graduate education, which is the cornerstone, in my opinion, of that mission, and inculcating undergraduate students in the research process. As a department head, I'm also always touched by the commitment of our supporters in the food industry and our alumni for supporting undergraduate students through scholarships. These make a big difference to our students financially, as you've heard in the case of Angie, and while rewarding their hard work and dedication to careers in the food industry in my discipline. In short, we cannot do it without you, and I'm very thankful to all of you for your unwavering support of the University of Arkansas. We now have a video that illustrates the significance of scholarships to the students who receive them, especially those who are first in their family to attend college.
Well, I wanted to go to college because my parents really pushed that on me. They didn't go to college, and so they wanted a better future for me.
Yeah, my mom didn't make that much money, and my stepdad, he worked hard as well. But yeah, if I hadn't had a scholarship, we wouldn't have been able to come out of pocket for me to come to the university at all.
I really don't know where I would be if I didn't come here. I think that I would probably be working in my hometown and being like a day-to-day job.
My parents are middle class, lower middle class, and we couldn't afford to pay for me to go to school here at all.
Last year, the average total cost of attending the University of Arkansas for in-state students was more than $23,500. While this is below the national average, it remains very costly for many families in Arkansas, where the median income was just over $41,000 in 2015. The challenge is, the best way to raise the median income of Arkansans is to raise their educational attainment.
I'm a first generation college student. My parents didn't know anything about how to do the financials of a college situation and things like that.
If scholarships were not in the picture, then my other options would have been community college or going to school part-time and working.
I probably would have been at home still working on my education, still pursuing higher education, but it would have been at a lower level. I probably would have had a job
A college degree doesn't just change the course of one generation. It alters the course of future generations. A recent poll indicated that 76% of those who had two parents with degrees entered a 2 or 4 year college immediately after high school. Conversely, if neither parent had a degree, the number dropped to 37%.
Having a degree will have a tremendous impact on my life simply because the field that I want to go into is always changing, it's always moving.
Whenever I do get my degree, and that'll allow me to get a job, and it'll allow me to live comfortably, and it'll give me a sense of being that I don't think that my family has ever felt.
My degree means just plenty of open doors.
I mean, it feels great to be able to come here and feel my dream of being, getting a degree from such a great college.
The University of Arkansas is committed to creating more scholarships for Arkansans, with an emphasis on first-generation Arkansans. With the help of private support, we hope to commit an additional $10 million a year to advance Arkansas scholarships. In so doing, we can help change the conversation for many Arkansas families, from whether their son or daughter will be able to attend college to which college they will graduate from.
I would not have been able to go to college without scholarships.
I wouldn't even be sitting in this spot. You wouldn't even be interviewing me.
Without them, I probably wouldn't be able to be in college.
Not having scholarships, work comes first, making sure that you have the money for your education, and having scholarships, school comes first, making sure you have the GPA to maintain those scholarships.
You know you're doing a great thing, but I don't think, honestly, how much you've impacted, I don't think you can see how much you impact our lives.
We will now begin awarding the next round of Towers of Old Main. Dave and Jane Gerhardt. The Gerhardts became members of the Towers of Old Main in 2001. Dave Gerhardt received a Doctor of Law and a Doctor of Education from the University of Arkansas. Jane Gerhardt holds a Bachelor of Science in Education from the university. Dave served as the fifth Chancellor of the University of Arkansas from 2008 to 2015. Jane is a member of the Women's Giving Circle, and the Jane B. Gerhardt Full Circle Food Pantry was named in her honor. Throughout the years, Dave and Jane have supported numerous areas on campus. They've also made a commitment to establish the Mark M. Brockman Access Arkansas Scholarship in memory of Jane's brother. In addition, Dave and his three brothers established the George A. Gerhardt Scholarship in honor of their late father for the benefit of students in the Department of Journalism. Dave and Jane Gerhardt, Gold Towers of Old Main. Grant Ginder and Katie Nelson Ginder. Grant Ginder holds a Bachelor of Science in Business Administration and a Graduate Certificate in Business Analytics from the University of Arkansas. Katie Nelson Ginder received both a Bachelor of Arts and Master of Arts in Communication from the university and serves as Assistant Vice Chancellor for the University Development. Katie and Grant have made a bequest to establish the Talmadge and Laverne Nelson Study Abroad Scholarship and the Grant Ginder and Katie Nelson Ginder International Excellence Fund for the benefit of the graduate school and international education and faculty and staff in the Walton College and Fulbright College. Grant Ginder and Katie Nelson Ginder, Towers of Old Main. David F. Grunewald. David F. Grunewald earned a Bachelor of Science in Electrical Engineering from the University of Arkansas. David is a member of the Heritage Society and a senior member of the Arkansas Academy of Electrical Engineering. He's also a member of the Chancellor's Society, Thoroughreds, and the Arkansas Alumni Association. He established the David V. F. Grunewald Endowed Chair in Renewable Energy to benefit the College of Engineering. In addition, David has generously supported multiple initiatives, including the Pi Kappa Alpha House Renovation Project and the Arkansas Academy of Electrical Engineering. David F. Grunewald, Gold Tower of Old Main. K. Denise Henderson. K. Denise Henderson became a member of the Towers of Old Main in 2015. She earned a Bachelor of Science in Home Economics from the University of Arkansas. Denise is a member of the Heritage Society, the Women's Giving Circle, and the Arkansas Alumni Association. She established both the K. Denise Henderson Endowed Scholarship benefiting human environmental sciences and the K. Denise Henderson Endowed Women's Giving Circle Fund. She's funded initiatives across campus, including the Mike and Chris Masechko Endowed Alumni Scholarship. K. Denise Henderson, Silver Tower of Old Main. Ben and Janet Heineman. Ben Heineman received a Bachelor of Science in Business Administration from the University of Arkansas. Janet Heineman received a Bachelor of Arts from the University of Arkansas. Ben and Janet are members of the Campaign Arkansas Steering Committee. Ben is chairman of the Board of Trustees and is a member of the Campaign Arkansas Bumpers and Division Unit Committee. Janet is the chair of the Campaign Arkansas University Libraries Unit Committee. Together, they established the Ben and Janet Heineman Leadership Endowment to benefit university libraries, as well as the Frank and Marzie Ann Heineman Endowed Scholarship to benefit the Sam M. Walton College of Business. They've also supported many other areas of the university. Ben and Janet Heineman, Towers of Old Main. Janice Faye Jones and Jean Cameron Jones. Jean Cameron Cammy Jones earned a Bachelor of Science in Education and a Master of Education from the University of Arkansas. She's a member of Thoroughreds and the Arkansas Alumni Association. Both Janice Faye Jones and Jean Cameron Jones are the daughters of E. Faye Jones and Mary Gus Jones. Faye Jones was an American Institute of Architects Gold Medal winner and was the first dean of the School of Architecture. In 2009, the school was renamed the Faye Jones School of Architecture in his honor. Together with their late parents, Cammie and Janice generously contributed to the Faye Jones School of Architecture through a family bequest. Janice Faye Jones and Jean Cameron Jones, Towers of Old Main. Jeffrey Lynn Koenig and Sarah VanZant Koenig. Jeffrey Lynn Koenig earned a Bachelor of Science in Electrical Engineering from the University of Arkansas. Jeffrey and Sarah are members of the Chancellor Society, Thoroughreds, and the Arkansas Alumni Association. Jeffrey is also a member of the Arkansas Academy of Electrical Engineering. Together, they established the Koenig Family Works Endowed Scholarship in Electrical Engineering. They've also generously supported multiple initiatives, including the Cornerstone House Fund and the Chancellor Society Fund. Jeffrey Lynn Koenig and Sarah VanZant Koenig, Towers of Old Main. Congratulations to these recipients. At this time, we'd like to thank the members of the Student Alumni Association who are acting as greeters tonight and assisting with the Towers induction ceremony. Our Student Alumni Association provides a much appreciated link between our current university students and our alumni. Would all of our Student Alumni Association members please stand and be recognized? Thank you. We now invite you to enjoy the second course of the evening, complemented by a musical improvisation from the Department of Theater and the Department of Music.
Let's call those hogs.
Ooh, pig suey.
Ooh,
pig suey.
Call those hogs.
Ooh,
pig suey.
Ooh,
pig suey.
Ooh,
pig suey.
Razorbacks.
And
we can.
No, you can.
Yes, we can. Yes, we can.
Anything you can be, we can be greater. Sooner or later, we're greater than you.
No, you're not.
Yes, we are.
No, you're not.
Yes, we are.
No, you're not.
Yes, we are. Yes, we are.
I can wave a banner in the quickest manner.
I can raise a foam hand higher than a tall man.
I can live on meat and drink.
And nothing lighter.
Sure.
So can a tiger.
Any note you can sing higher.
I can sing any note higher than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
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 Anything you can buy, I can buy cheaper. I can buy anything cheaper than you.
50 cents.
40 cents.
30 cents.
20 cents.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can. Yes, I can.
Anything you can say, I can say softer.
Softer than you.
No, you can't.
Go Hogs.
Go Hogs.
Go Hogs.
Go Hogs.
Go Hogs!
I can sing the fight song and not get any words wrong.
I can do it better while dancing every letter.
I can recite every name.
On senior walk?
Sure.
No, you cannot lie.
Any note you can hold, I can hold longer.
I can hold any note longer than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
Better than you.
In my glasses.
In your scarf.
In my tie.
In your hat.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can. Yes, I can.
Anything you can say faster.
I can say anything faster than you.
Go Hawks.
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 Go Hawks. Pig nose.
I can strike a cool pose.
I can run to Old Main.
Yeah, but you look so lame.
I can find most anything.
A parking spot for your
no!
Yeah, it's too far.
Anything you can sing, I can sing sweeter.
We can sing anything sweeter than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't. No, you can't.
Yes, we can.
No, you can't. Can't.
Yes,
yes,
we can.
We would now like to welcome our next co-host, Dr. Ann O'Leary Kelly. She's the Senior Associate Dean and William R. and Cecilia Howard Chair in Management in the Sam M. Walton College of Business. She's written and edited numerous publications on her research interest, which includes the study of gender-related aggressive work behavior and individual attachments to organizations. Please welcome Dr. Ann O'Leary Kelly.
Good evening. I hope everyone is enjoying the evening. We've talked a little bit about how important private support is to students and faculty. Most of you are probably aware that we recently announced the university's 8 guiding principles. One of those priorities is building a collaborative and innovative campus. Our next video showcases a new laboratory made possible by private support that exemplifies that effort. Let's take a look.
We've all had the experience of waiting in line while the checker struggles to scan the barcode on an awkwardly shaped item, and watched as they attempted to scan it over and over and over again. The solution? Full package watermarking, which would enable checkers to scan anywhere on the package for the barcode and move up to 400% faster. This is just the kind of experimental technology the Macmillan Family Retail Innovation and Technology Studio was designed to help test and develop.
What we do in the Macmillan Innovation Lab is that we always are challenging ourselves with real-life examples and problems. So we are a team that we work in different projects with different companies, and then we're always helping them to innovate in like their different issues and problems and having a new product.
Our main goal is help produce the students that will create the next generation of retail innovation. Because of the Macmillan Innovation Studio, to really be at the forefront of that and really help develop skills in students that when they get in the marketplace, they are ready to hit the ground running on making really big differences for those companies.
The Macmillan Innovation Studio was made possible by a gift from Doug and Shelley Macmillan. As a graduate of the university and CEO of the largest retailer on earth, Walmart Stores Incorporated, Doug has an interest in supporting the Walton College while advancing the science of retailing.
Being interdisciplinary is really a big deal. Small teams working together quickly to solve problems in a collaborative fashion is the model for the future.
I think it's just, as Doug said, a great opportunity to get kids involved, letting them design projects and seeing them come to fruition there.
The philanthropy of Doug and Shelley was a game changer. Because of their support, it gave us access to a broad network of people. And so I think without that generosity, there's no doubt in my mind we wouldn't be where we are today and our future wouldn't be as bright.
18 to 20 students currently work at the studio, a mix of undergraduate and graduate. And they come from a range of disciplines, including mechanical and industrial engineering, computer science, logistics, and marketing.
For my academic career, this means a lot because it gives me the opportunity to work with a real-world company to kind of see, as far as the industrial engineering aspect of the optimization and the supply chain network, how a real company works. It's a great opportunity for me to really get in there and not just sit in a classroom. We can actually see how it works and help them improve their sales, improve their network.
Ultimately, the Macmillan Innovation Studio is a hands-on way to generate new ideas, create a community around retail innovation, and showcase the possibilities of a career in the industry.
My vision of the future is just continued growth of the individuals that are involved, more students involved, more faculty involved, other potential alumni or stakeholders of what we're doing in the Innovation Studio, but certainly part of that innovation dialogue that is so prevalent in business today.
The video clearly demonstrates the impact that philanthropy can have on creating innovative programs for our students. It seems very fitting to show the video at this event, where we honor and thank university friends and benefactors. Like my colleagues who already have spoken, I'm honored to share my perspective about the power and impact that your support has had on the University of Arkansas. I arrived at the university in 1997, and like most young faculty, had little understanding of the necessity or impact of philanthropy to the work that's done at great universities. I didn't know what a capital campaign was, I had never met any development officer, and I had not given much thought to the funding model for universities. I'm a little chagrined to say that now, out loud, given my role. Dean Waller, please don't fire me. But shortly after my arrival on campus, I entered my office one morning to find a can of Sam's Choice Cola on my desk. The can had a red ribbon and a card that invited me to a mysterious event later that day. I had no earthly idea what this was all about, but that little can of soda started my education in the power of philanthropy. At the event, the university announced what was, at the time, the largest endowment ever given to a college of business. My new employer was no longer the College of Business, it was the Sam M. Walton College of Business. And our college began a transformation that still consumes and drives us today. We hired new faculty whose research brought visibility and helped us become a ranked business school. We added technology that transformed our teaching capabilities. With external partners, we created outreach centers that allow us to bring business knowledge into the classroom and to take our research out into business. These are all significant changes, but the true power of transformation was driven by the fact that this investment in our college caused us to raise our expectations of ourselves and to set higher goals. Someone had expressed profound faith in us, and to this day, we strive to be worthy of that faith and investment. So the key lesson I've learned about philanthropy is that it does not just affect the stuff that a university has access to, it affects the fundamental sense of self and place of the people and of the institution. I've learned firsthand that the combination of financial support, strong and strategic leadership, and the actions of talented, committed people within and outside the university is truly magical. I've described how philanthropy has influenced my college, the Walton College, but this story has taken place across our beloved campus. Your support has allowed us to work toward what I believe is exactly the spot a university should occupy during this time when industry disruption is challenging all educational institutions. Because of your support, the University of Arkansas is widely recognized as a best value university, a best return on investment university, and an up-and-coming university. We're known as an institution that provides a high-quality education, but also as an institution that works hard to do this in a financially accessible way. For me, this aligns very well with my beliefs about the cultural identity of Arkansas. I think it's a place where we get the job done well, we do it without getting too full of ourselves or too fancy, and we surprise a whole lot of people along the way. So thank you for being a critical part of the equation that's brought us to this point in the university's history. I'm grateful to have had the opportunity to spend so much of my career in this wonderful place. Thank you. We will now begin awarding the final round of towers.
David R. Malone and Deborah Thomas. David R. Malone received a Bachelor of Science in Business Administration, a Master of Business Administration, and Juris Doctor from the University of Arkansas, Deborah Thomas received a Master of Science in Accounting from the University of Arkansas. David and Deborah are members of the Chancellor Society, Thoroughreds, Library Leadership Council, and the Arkansas Alumni Association. The David R. Malone Scholarship was established to benefit the law school and the David R. Malone Special Collections Endowment Fund for the University of Arkansas Libraries. David R. Malone and Deborah Thomas, Towers of Old Main. James E. McClelland, Jr. and Patricia F. McClelland. James E. McClelland earned a Bachelor of Science in Civil Engineering from the University of Arkansas. Patricia F. McClelland also attended the University of Arkansas. James is a member of the Arkansas Academy of Civil Engineering. He also serves on the Engineering Dean's Advisory Council, the Campaign Arkansas Campaign Steering Committee, and is chair of the Campaign Arkansas Engineering Unit Committee. The McClellands have generously supported multiple initiatives on campus, including the Civil Engineering Research and Education Center. They also established the J.E. and Maurice A. McClelland Endowed Scholarship in Civil Engineering. James E. McClelland, Jr. and Patricia F. McClelland, Towers of Old Main. Lucas D. and Janet H. Parsh. Lucas Parsh is an emeritus faculty member, having served as an associate professor of agricultural economics and agribusiness. Janet H. Parsh earned a Master of Public Administration in Political Science from the University of Arkansas. Janet and Lucas Parsh are both members of the Campaign Arkansas Graduate School and International Education Research and Economic Development Unit Committee. Together, they funded the Lucas and Janet Parsh Endowed International Student Scholarship. They've generously supported multiple initiatives, including the International Programs Fund and KUAF. Lucas D. and Janet H. Parsh, Towers of Old Main. Dennis and Evelyn Shaw. Dennis Shaw received a Bachelor of Science in Business Administration and a Master of Business Administration from the University of Arkansas. Evelyn Shaw received both a Bachelor of Arts and a Master of Arts in Speech and Dramatic Arts from the university. Dennis is a member of the Campaign Arkansas Steering Committee and Campaign Arkansas At-Large Regional Committee. The Shaws have made a commitment to benefit the Sam M. Walton College of Business Excellence Fund. Other initiatives they've supported include the Pi Kappa Alpha House renovation project and the G. David and Jane Brockman Gerhardt Endowed Scholarship. Dennis and Evelyn Shaw, Towers of Old Main. Anne Marie Ziegler. Anne Marie Ziegler is a University of Arkansas Emeritus Faculty member. She's also a member of the Heritage Society, Chancellor Society, and Thoroughreds. Anne Marie and her late husband, Joseph Ziegler, funded numerous initiatives at the University of Arkansas. Anne continues to support the university and created the Dr. Joseph A. Ziegler Experimental Economics Excellence Fund in memory of her late husband. She also established the Therese Rickert Endowed Nursing Scholarship, the Meredith Warner Endowed Nursing Scholarship, and the Kristen Coleman Endowed Nursing Scholarship in honor of three former university students. Anne Marie Ziegler, Tower of Old Main. Charles R. and Susan D. Zimmerman. Charles R. Zimmerman received a Bachelor of Science in Civil Engineering from the University of Arkansas. Charles and Susan are members of the Heritage Society and Thoroughreds. Charles is also a member of the Arkansas Academy of Civil Engineering, the Arkansas Alumni Association, and serves on the Engineering Dean's Advisory Council and the Campaign Arkansas Engineering Unit Committee. The Zimmermans have made a commitment to establish the Charles R. and Susan D. Zimmerman Endowed Scholarship to benefit the College of Engineering. Charles R. and Susan D. Zimmerman, Towers of Old Main. Joseph and Sandra Steinmetz. Dr. Joseph E. Steinmetz became the sixth Chancellor of the University of Arkansas in January 2016. Joe is a member of the Arkansas Research Alliance Board of Directors and the Faculty Senate. Both Joe and Sandy are in the Chancellor Society, and Sandy is a lifetime member of the Women's Giving Circle. Together, they funded several initiatives on campus, including the Women's Giving Circle, and have also established the Chancellor's Advance Arkansas Endowed Scholarship. Joe and Sandy Steinmetz, Towers of Old Main. Congratulations to all these recipients, and thanks to all of our Towers of Old Main. If you're a Tower of Old Main, would you now please stand and be recognized? Thank you so much. This concludes the induction portion of tonight's ceremony. We now invite you to enjoy the third and final course of the evening with another performance from the Department of Theater and Department of Music. Our program will resume in a few minutes. Please enjoy.
Forever and ever.
We would now like to welcome our fourth and final faculty co-host of the night. Kevin Hall is a professor in the Department of Civil Engineering and holds the Walter E. Hicks and Blossom Russell Hicks Endowed Professorship in Infrastructure Engineering in the College of Engineering. He's also the executive director of the Mack Blackwell Transportation Center at the University of Arkansas. Since joining the U of A in 1993 as an associate professor, Hall has received numerous awards and honors, including both the College of Engineering Outstanding Researcher Award and Outstanding Teacher Award in Civil Engineering, the U of A Distinguished Faculty Achievement Award for Teaching and Research, and the Associated Student Government's Most Outstanding Faculty Award. Please welcome Dr. Kevin Hall.
Thank you. It's truly an honor and a pleasure to join you tonight to celebrate the tremendous generosity and passion that you provide to our great university. You've heard from some of my colleagues about the impact of philanthropy that has had on their careers as well as on the lives of their students. I have similar stories to tell. As a department head, I've personally witnessed what scholarship support can do. One young lady came to my office in her freshman year wanting to study abroad in Belize. Unfortunately, the financial burden was too great for her family. At the 11th hour, I was able to provide scholarship support from our alumni donors to enable the trip. Now, this young lady went on to study abroad three times, including prestigious research experiences in both Denmark and South Africa. She completed her bachelor's degree as the most decorated graduate in the department's history, earning both a Fulbright Fellowship and a National Science Foundation Graduate Research Fellowship. She's currently completing her PhD at the University of Virginia and credits the scholarship support that she received by enabling her to reach heights she could barely dream of as a freshman. Now, while the level of her accomplishment is unique, her level of financial need is not. On numerous occasions over the past 10 years, I've had students come to my office with the news that they were, unfortunately, forced to leave the University of Arkansas due to financial difficulties. Some simply said, "Dr. Hall, I just don't know what I'm going to do." Others expressed the hope that, well, maybe after working 6 months or a year, they might be able to return. Now, many of these kids were first-generation college students, and most were from Arkansas. On every occasion, I was able to find scholarship funds from our alumni donors to keep that student in school. And I can confidently say that in each instance, that particular student graduated from our program. So please don't ever doubt the power and effectiveness of scholarship support to literally change a student's life. I'd also like to echo my colleagues' appreciation of endowed positions. The department head position in civil engineering carries an endowed chair, the 21st Century Leadership Chair in Civil Engineering. Proceeds from the chair provide tremendous flexibility to the department head to encourage and enable faculty, staff, and students with opportunities which otherwise couldn't be funded. In the 9 years since the chair was activated, faculty have traveled to important technical and professional conferences to share their work and hear about work going on around the world. Graduate students have been financially supported to cover shortfalls in research dollars, particularly for longer-term research efforts. Equipment has been purchased to keep both graduate and undergraduate laboratories truly state-of-the-art. And international education and research experience for students have been made much more affordable. So in short, what does an endowed chair help us do? Well, a little bit of everything. And all of it is good for faculty and students. Now, when I consider the lives that are touched and changed through the philanthropy that you have shown, thank you seems much too tame of a word, but I do offer it in all sincerity. Thank you. So before I go, please permit me to introduce our next speaker. After a little more than a year on the job, he's been rolling out new initiatives left and right, including the Advanced Arkansas Scholarship Program mentioned in the previous video, and the new Chancellor's Discovery, Creativity, Innovation, and Collaboration Fund. With the establishment of the university's 8 guiding priorities, we can expect a lot more in the months and years ahead. So please welcome Chancellor Joe Steinmetz.
Thank you, Kevin, and I want to thank all of your colleagues who are here tonight as well. I really appreciate your willingness to share your very interesting stories. They're actually a very powerful testament to the impact of private gift support that impact has had on your success and the success of our students. You know, time and again, I come back to the notion of how lucky our students and faculty are to have people like our Towers of Old Main, people willing to share the benefits of their hard work with strangers. If you'll indulge me in just a few minutes, I'd like to talk a little bit about my own college experience. When I was in college, there wasn't a lot of scholarship monies available. Some of that was because I was an undergraduate at Central Michigan University in Michigan, which didn't have an endowment that you might expect that you'd see at a large university. I could have used a scholarship because my parents couldn't pay for my education. I had two older brothers in college at the same time and two younger siblings waiting to go. My family's financial situation just didn't allow for my parents to help with the financial support for college. I was going to have to do that on my own. So I had to work my way through college in a variety of jobs during the school year and throughout the summer. So my jobs included, and this is probably a partial list, working weeknights at the front desk in a residence hall, nighttime security in a housing project. I served as an electrician's assistant for a while, and I was a meat cutter in a butcher shop. And yes, also, I was a rock and roll star on the weekends. Sandy disputes that, but it was the truth. Sandy and I married while I was an undergraduate, so she made a significant contribution to our income during that time. And she delayed her own education so that I could finish mine. I continued to work at the butcher shop while I was working on my master's degree as well. And Sandy continued to work while I was working on my PhD. And of course, there is a lot to be said for working hard and staying the course. I know right now, standing here, there's a certain satisfaction I have in taking the steep path to my goal, just to prove you have what it takes. And there's a great sense of accomplishment in this. But the truth is really the following. At any given moment, I think we were one financial crisis away from disaster and throwing in the towel on the whole thing. Perhaps if I dropped out, I would be managing a butcher shop now, or a rock star, one of the two things. And by the way, I was pretty good at deboning chickens, and I could cut a chicken up in less than 20 seconds. That would be a skill very applicable around here right now. So if anyone needs chickens cut up, let me know. I certainly couldn't at that time foresee at all where my academic career would take me. And while there's something to be said about doing it on your own, there's perhaps more to be said about able to seize the opportunity that a college campus can provide. I've heard our new provost, Jim Coleman, mention that the opportunity to do undergraduate research transformed his life and actually set him on an entirely new career path. And we saw earlier how Dr. Roger Kepi has broadened the opportunities of his students by partnering with them as research partners. Similar to Jim, I had an undergraduate research experience that eventually set me on a path of becoming a neuroscientist. But I do remember the great effort it took to get to class, work 30 hours or more a week, and still try to carve out hours to gain the very valuable research experience I enjoyed. And that's the main reason why Sandy and I wanted to make sure we supported Advanced Arkansas. We know how hard it is to persevere, especially as both of us were first-generation college students. We know how tempting it is to buckle under that financial pressure and call it quits. And we have data that shows right here, unfortunately, that that happens much too often. The greater your financial need, the more likely you are to drop out. And we know now and how having to work long hours can actually impoverish your college experience and limit what you learn and the time you do to have the full college experience. And so I'm so very grateful that there are people like you willing to transform the lives of others. I think it's one of the greatest gifts you can give to someone. So thank you for all making all our dreams come true here at the University of Arkansas. Thank you. At this time, we're going to award our Chancellor's Medals. First awarded in 1993, the Chancellor's Medal recognizes individuals who, quote, render extraordinary service to higher education and to society at large. There are some past Chancellor Medal recipients here tonight, and I'd like for you to recognize them at this time. If you would, please stand when your name is called. Lee Bodenhammer. We're so glad you can make it today, and we're thankful for all you do. So thank everything to you for what you've done for our university. This year, the University of Arkansas is pleased to recognize three outstanding individuals as Chancellor's Medal recipients. To get things started, we turn to the people who knew them best and know them best and have loved them the longest. Please direct your attention to the screens for the first video about two of tonight's honorees.
I have known Bob and Sandra all of my adult life, and Jay and I have been good, sweet friends with Sandra and Bob for as long as I can remember.
Well, I've actually known Sandra longer than I've known Bob. I met Sandra in probably 1963. I met Bob in the 70s. We both lived in Little Rock, and Bob was working at Union National Bank that his father-in-law owned and ran. Somebody, either his father-in-law or Bob, asked me to be on the board.
When I think about Mom and Dad, first thing that comes to my mind is how much they give. And I really don't know anybody that gives as much as they do. And they're always trying to think of a way to give somebody something if they're in need or just to help somebody out. And I've always admired that in Mom and Dad.
Yeah, when Mom asks someone about their family, she means it. She wants to know. They have the most genuine hearts, and they truly have concern and care for other people like I've really never seen before.
The best thing about Sandra and Bob is their generosity and their love for mankind and wanting to make this world a better place for many different people.
Oh, this is our favorite.
This is from Hawaii in 2014.
They're the best grandparents.
They really are.
Our kids love them.
Mom and Dad, yeah, they do. And they are so sweet. They love to take us all somewhere every couple years, and this was in Hawaii with all the grandkids. It's still my kids' favorite memories, is all these trips they take us on and just how much fun it is and how giving they are to take us all and these fabulous experiences. They always want us to have new experiences.
Bob and Sandra are two of the greatest people in the state of Arkansas, and they have real love for the university, and they really have worked for several years on this campaign that we're now involved in, really helped kick it off, and I think, in my opinion, did a great job because the campaign's going very well.
When Laura was in school up there, I know that Sandra and Bob spent a good bit of time on the campus. I think that was Bob's introduction to the University of Arkansas. But also, I know that Bob is a smart, savvy businessman, and Bob knows the important role that the University of Arkansas plays in the economic development of our state. He sees that, and he sees that importance, and that really solidifies his commitment to the university.
And I think he has adopted it. I mean, I think he loves the university just as much as Mom.
And this is kind of their heartbeat, is the University of Arkansas and education. That's always such a big deal to them. Education is really important to them. And since this has been such great memories for Mom, and then having a grandchild who's already there and one who's going and a daughter who's an alumni, I mean, it's just been real special to them.
There's no one best part about Connor. He's just great all around.
They are great friends of the university because they've given their heart and soul over many, many years to the university. They've been there to help various individuals on campus. They've been there to help the administration. They have just been there to help make the university a better place.
Sandra's got an unusual sense of humor. It's like she's needling you a little bit, but it's always meant in good humor.
They have a good time. They have a good time together. Mm-hmm. They like I said, they spend a lot of time together on road trips and on, you know, with us. And I think they have a great time together. And
we've nicknamed Dad Clark Griswold because something always happens. Dad always does something goofy.
He does. He does.
And I remember vacations because of what Dad's done. So that's fun to me.
We always had a lot of road trips growing up. We had, we actually had two large vans. And Dad, you know, loved to get in the car. We would drive all over. Of course, the five of us and sometimes friends. He still likes to drive to this day. Mom and Dad still get in the car and drive.
He's not a great driver, but he loves to drive. Sorry, Dad.
He's not the best.
We've had a couple little incidents.
Oh, he's rear-ended people on the LA freeway.
We've had a couple of things.
Now, I see Sandra and Bob as a very strong, committed couple to each other. And to be honest, that doesn't happen with every couple. I've always thought and said, with Sandra and Bob, you get two for the price of one.
What a wonderful tribute. Sandra, Bob, congratulations. Will you please join me on stage? Sandra and Bob, you are true champions of this university and have tirelessly supported our faculty and our students. You routinely step up to volunteer your time and have made significant and lasting investments in our university. This has included the Robert C. and Sandra Connor Endowed Faculty Fellowship for Assistant Professors in the J. William College of Arts and Sciences, and both the Sandra and Robert Connor Access Arkansas Scholarship and the G. David and Jane Brockman Gearhart Endowed Scholarship. For everything you've done for our university and for our state, I'm honored to present you with the University of Arkansas's Chancellor's Medal. Thank you so much. Congratulations to both of you on behalf of the entire university community. We greatly appreciate your dedication and long-term support of this university. Now please turn your attention to the screen to learn about our next Chancellor's Medal recipient.
Oh, I think if you ask many people about Margaret, it's just her warmth, it's her sincerity, her engagement.
It's just Margaret's nature to connect.
She's persistent. She never gives up. You can always count on Margaret Willock.
One of my first memories of my mother is teaching me and teaching all of us to treat everyone the same.
She's always been a major, major part of who I am and my morals and everything I've done, and she's been a big part of a lot of the big decisions I've made in my life.
Very honored to be included in her circle of friends. Margaret was a delight in her work and her friendship.
Margaret's smart. She knows how to get from A to B in the right way. She'll always do her part, and she's absolutely just a straight shooter, impeccable integrity.
Margaret is so interested in people and keeps up with your family and your interests not only for me, but for all of her friends.
It was a dream come true to have Margaret in the White House. She made every single visitor to the White House feel special and taken care of.
She started out teaching school in Springdale.
Education was always a guiding premise. Our grandparents were very well educated for those times, and we always knew that education was very important to our mother. And she speaks really fondly about her Pi Phi days.
As a pledge, we all loved Margaret because she had this beautiful smile, and she was interested in each one of us and what we were interested in.
She used to tell us that going to school was our job. She was like, I do this job, Carl does this job, and your job is going to school, and your responsibility is taking care of your, you know, your schoolwork and your education.
We like to say all of us married Carl Willock. We were crazy about him.
Can you imagine marrying a woman with six children that are these ages? And, you know, we just always had a loving home that was open and welcoming to everyone.
She is the most devoted mother that I've ever known.
Heck, she can never forget a birthday, ever. And she'll tell all the cousins and everybody else when a birthday is coming up of another cousin, just to make sure that you tell them happy birthday and reach out to them. So she's definitely been a glue of this family.
I think the best thing would be all of my siblings I have, all the family that she's made.
I think one of the best things about her mother is her attitude. Mm-hmm. She just wakes up in the morning and is 100% positive.
She's our mom. That's the greatest thing about her. We were born and there she was. You know, for a lot of things in the world that could have happened, that who could our mother could have been, without question, we hit the jackpot when we came into this world. And she was our mom.
I think she's always had a fondness for Northwest Arkansas. And when she had the opportunity to move back to Fayetteville and be close to some of her children there, she has been a very staunch supporter of the university in so many instances. When I've talked to her, she'll say, well, I'm doing this for the university, or I'm working on that for the university.
The university's had a huge impact on her life and our lives in return, and I know she truly feels honored, and not just honored, but it's a calling to give back. She wants to give back to the university.
She's really contributed to the institution to make it better, and she's a person of real accomplishment and achievement, and she's done it in the right way, and she's done it over many years. You know, she's had a level of consistency and sustained engagement making our state a better place. So she's just enormously worthy of this recognition. I'm pleased for her and proud of her, as is my wife, Donna.
I genuinely believe that it was a surprise, and it's the giving back that she and Carl both did for the university.
She's just so honored. She's very kind of humble about it, didn't really expect anything like that. It's something that's been important to her that she shares with all of us.
This award was definitely a big deal, and she was very honored. You know, everybody in the family heard about it. You know, she was telling me about it. I couldn't be happier. She got the award.
She's poured her heart and soul into the university, and receiving this award is a reflection of how much the university values her contributions.
So well deserved, so well deserved. Margaret loves the university and has always been so faithful to the university. It's a great honor, and it is something that I know she will cherish.
That was great. Congratulations, Margaret. Would you please join me on stage? Margaret, you've made a lasting impact on our university. Your volunteerism, your philanthropic support has touched nearly every part of our campus. This has included support for the university's libraries, the Carl and Margaret Willock Endowment for the School of Social Work, the Pi Beta Phi Centennial Gate, the Alumni House Campaign, the Fulbright Peace Fountain, and the Old Main Clock Tower. So for everything you've done for our university, and for our state, and personally for Sandy and me, I'm honored to present you with the University of Arkansas's Chancellor's Medal. Thank you so much, Margaret. Congratulations on behalf of the entire university community. We greatly appreciate everything you've done for the university. This concludes the awarding of tonight's Chancellor's Medal, so thank you so very much.
Once again, please welcome Vice Chancellor for Advancement, Mark Power.
Well, what a night, huh? This has been terrific. Let me also offer my congratulations to Sandra and Bob and to Margaret. You've been dear friends to me and my family, and I know you have many, many friends and supporters here tonight, and so very thankful, and we're all very blessed to have you in our lives, so thank you very much. Well, as we begin to wrap up the night, I want to also thank our faculty co-hosts for their work tonight. If you would, please give them a round of applause. We're very grateful you could be here tonight, and I know everyone really appreciated hearing from you about the value of philanthropy from your perspective. Also, thank you to Michael Rhea, Jason Burrow, Jeannie Lee from the Department of Theater, and Jake Herzog from the Department of Music for their work with our student performers tonight. They were truly outstanding. I also want to thank our announcer, James Spencer, as well as everyone in university relations, donor relations and special events, and university development who have worked so hard to make this evening so special. They are a great team. Thank you. And finally, let me thank all of our Towers of Old Main here tonight. The university has made great strides in recent decades, and philanthropy has fueled much of that progress. We simply couldn't do it without you. I hope we've been able to convey some small measure of our gratitude for your generosity and your involvement in the life of this university. So thank you. We'll end tonight with a final song from Trey O'Dell and students from the Department of Theater. So good night and take care.
Journeys to plan 525,600.
remember the